Hello and welcome to my guide on how to approach Pokémon Unite and how to play to improve once the game is released. The game comes out in a few days and everyone is hyped to play it and reach a rank as high as possible and want to become the best player they could possibly be. I'm here to try to set you up on the right path for that. So without further ado, let's go and start right ahead. The first things you probably ask yourself, how much should I play the game and in what intervals? Is playing more or less better? The answer is a bit more complicated because there are two types of playing the game. You can either play focused and think about the game, or be on autopilot, just doing what you do without reasoning and maybe are sidetracked by other stuff. Playing on autopilot doesn't help you improving at all basically, and it's more of a time waste than anything else. You should rather play 2 hours of concentrated Unite than 15 hours on autopilot. It's like in school, if you pay attention and try hard, can learn more in one lesson than in an entire semester if you don't bother listen to your teacher and don't do your homework, etc. So we want to reduce games played on autopilot and maximize games played focused. To do that, you usually play sessions and do breaks in between them in which you do something to refresh your mind, like sport or chilling or whatever. Those gaming sessions usually last in between somewhere of 1 to 3 hours, depending on how well you feel and how long you can focus, but that's not set in stone, it's just a reference and can be completely different from person to person. Also, when you feel like you cannot focus or you have a bad day, you don't need to force yourself to do the entire session. It would be just time waste. In that time, you should rather do something to feel better again or do some tasks which don't require your full attention. You can choose how many sessions you want to do based on your personal free time or how you feel. Pro players usually would do like 5 sessions per day, and standard humans more like 1 or 2 sessions a day. You should do what fits best for you. Taking breaks is also okay if you feel like it. Now we know on how to use time effectively to improve, and next up is how to use that time actually to score good results. At the beginning of the day, you should set yourself a goal or thing you want to work on today. You can choose whatever it is, but this should be something related to what's completely in your control, like a camera control or doing combos correctly on your mon, rather than getting a higher rank or something like that. Your goal should be something which improves your gameplay and not something fancy like your rank or stuff like that. If you only focus on rank, etc., that won't help you improve on the long run, and it's a very toxic feeling if you don't win, even if the games were out of your control. Basically, if your goal is to win every game, you already failed, because it's mathematically proven that it's impossible to win every game. Even the best of the best will lose every 4th or 5th game he plays in the beginning, and even more with time progressing, people getting better. And feeling bad every day is poison for your mental and will hold you back quite a lot. So don't get in a habit to care about your rank or stuff like that. To focus on our self-set goal, we want to reduce the other stuff we need to think about. To do that, we will play the same Pokémon on the same lane as much as possible. If you play a different Pokémon and lane every time, you cannot think about the game that much because you need to think about your Pokémon all the time. You have to read what their moves are and what they do. And even if you know all of it, you need to get used to playing that Pokémon, etc. So it's a lot of thought process invested into how you play your Pokémon. If your main Pokémon gets taken away, or you have to play a different lane, then go ahead and play your secondary Mon on lane. This doesn't mean, however, that you should your lifetime only play one Pokémon. You should rather be incentivized to spam 1-2 Pokémon for every, like at least 50 to 100 games, and use them at least in 80% of your games in that period. That does not only help you concentrating on the aspects of the game you're training and improving on, but also gives you the confidence and practice on that certain Pokémon. It's also a lot easier for your brain to learn with this method. If you study for your math test, you don't train 5 minutes one subject and switch for another 5 and do it all the time, because then you cannot focus on your mind on one thing and it's less effective. By spamming one Pokémon, you get its combos, etc. in your muscle memory by being able to focus on different aspects of the game. Also, there's a saying, Like a skilled swordsman is more afraid of a person who wielded one sword 100 times than 100 swords one time. Since the amount of things you can think about at a given time is limited, you want to minimize to think about stuff which you can do subconsciously. Things like how to use your combos on a given Pokemon, etc., are the first layer of things you can train to get them into your subconsciousness. If you have done that, you can think about other stuff. If you have done that, you can think about other stuff like where should I move my camera or in what order should I do camps, etc., which also become more and more subconscious with time moving forward. If you think about it enough, you basically start seeing patterns and answers to certain plays. Then, if you see A, you can subconsciously react with B, and if A is a bit different from what you have had in your mind, you slightly vary this difference out by doing B a bit different, basically. You simplify basically what you think about in structures and models to be able to think about more at a given time. But one thing which is very important to keep in mind is that a model is only usable if its requirements are met. Otherwise, it doesn't work anymore. So you should understand why you are eligible to use the model and what its requirements are. It's really, really important. Only knowing answers to questions, but not understanding how to derive to the answer, is a scary thing. It's like knowing a mathematic formula, but not understanding what it actually means or how to derive it. Malicious coaches, for example, try to temporarily fix your problems with constructs which they don't explain, which works till a certain threshold, but then you cannot step any further and you are forced to get back to them to learn the next temporary fix and get stuck paying him with seemingly progress. This warning has not to do too much with this video, but I just wanted you to warn you about it. A good coach cares only for intention and explains you why what you are doing is bad basically. But now let's move on with the next point. As I just stated, you should be sparing only one to two Pokemon at a given time in one lane or for a longer moment of time. Even if you believe you are a magically chosen guy who's destined to play each and every Pokemon in every single role, you should learn one Pokemon in one lane after another. Focusing on one certain thing to a certain degree and then moving on to the next part is way more effective than trying to soak up everything and learn 20 things at once. So please don't just say yeah, that makes sense and progress to play eight different Pokemon in your last 20 matches. Thank you. Meta changes on new builds, etc., are no exception to this rule. You should still spam your Pokemon in your lane, even if it's not the best at it. You try to improve and you don't play for temporary Elo points, which have no inherent value in itself yet. However, no one is stopping you from spamming the one which is the best in the meta or which has the funniest new build. One advice I can give you though is that spamming simplistic Pokemon designs are the best to play because advantages you generate don't come from mechanics, but rather from being at the right time at the right moment. Basically, playing a Pokemon where you cannot hide behind in having better mechanics than your opponent is usually a good way to show how good you are in a game. Just because a Pokemon has simple combos, it's just not a noob Pokemon. If a pro plays a Pokemon with simple combos, he will still carry the game, but the amateur would not be able to carry with the same Pokemon. A lot of the skill doesn't come from being able to mechanically be able to pilot a Pokemon, but on how you play the game in general. A pro will also be able to pick up first time a newly released Pokemon and still play pretty well on it, despite never having played it before. You should also, if possible, restrain yourself from playing support and jungle, because usually in those lanes there is a lot less PvP incentivized gameplay and a lot more inaccurate inputs are more forgiven. In those roles, the important skills are being at the right time at the right moment. These skills are really important. However, you can learn these skills just as much in playing other lanes or reviewing your games, while PvP skills and input accuracy is a skill you only get by training a lot. So it's really hard to get to play lane if you start off by playing jungle or support, because you haven't trained PvP. On the other hand, it's easier to get to play jungle or support by starting from lane. So try to avoid being jungle or support main. This doesn't mean that you are bad at PvP if you play like jungle, but that's a thing you should at least keep in your mind by playing non-PvP incentivized roles. One really helpful and important thing you should do is reviewing your own games. If you watch your replays, then you can see what mistakes you do a lot, which you might not realize while you're playing the game. On my channel you should find a video about how to review your games more in depth, but I give a few points here. You should focus mainly on your intent rather on how you played concretely in the game itself. You should always ask yourself what were you thinking and why, and look if it was correct to think that way or where the problem was. And if you thought correct, if you just mechanically misplayed or what went wrong. If you haven't thought of anything in that time of the game, you were on autopilot, this is bad and should not happen. You should focus mainly on laning phase in your analysis, because laning phase, you get to play every game, and laning phase is the purest and most fundamental form of the game. If you were able to understand laning phase deeply and intricately, you should be able to identify and spot and hone in on the mistakes surrounding fights and objectives. Next to intent, the other thing you should be focusing on in your replays are the fundamentals. You should rather think about if your camera was moved at the right position or if you were spacing correctly, rather than did I pick the best Pokemon or how close a fight was or some useless other information. Pokemon Unite sadly doesn't have a replay tool yet, so you need to record games on your own. And because it's on Switch, it's a bit harder to do. But I think you can find a device to connect your Switch to PC for like 15 euro. If that's out of your cards, then just record with your phone or something like that. The quality might not be the best with it, but if you upload it on YouTube unlisted and watch it for yourself, you might still be able to spot mistakes, even if it looks horrendous and is a bit extra work. But if you really want to improve and work on your gameplay, you should find a way to watch your replays and analyze them. You should not only watch your own gameplay, but you should also watch streams from high-ranked players and see how they play and what they do different compared to you. Keep in mind that the game is new, so even those pros will do a shit ton of mistakes and have a lot of bad habits, etc. You should just try to filter out the things they do better than you and adapt them to your gameplay. It's like a skilled swordsman collecting ideas and tips from other skilled swordsmen in order to become the very best the world ever saw. You should keep true to your playstyle, but learn and understand all the styles. Knowing what your opponent does allows you to play your style on a higher level, because you know what is possible and what not for the opponent, so you can do some things which you could not do otherwise. The next question becomes, how much time from my session should I invest in reviewing and how much in playing? You should always be playing like one session a day, basically, if you want to really improve. And you have time for more sessions, it should be 60-70% review and the rest playing. These numbers don't come from any credible source, I just made them up as a reference of my beliefs and what I've seen from players and what I've heard. Also, it depends from person to person and problem to problem what is the best for each individual. So do it in a way that works best for you. If you are only able to do like one session a day, I would say that on 2 days you should focus solely on review structure, and on some sessions you should do mixture of playing and review based on how you feel that day. Just keep in mind that reviewing is an important part of improving in the game. Another really important thing is that if you tend to tilt a lot, meaning you are getting like upset or unfocused because of things happening in the game or out of the game, you should really try to reduce that. Playing on tilt is even worse than playing on autopilot. If you get mad because you get camped, or rage because people are not playing optimal, or something, you get sidetracked and you might even play intentionally worse than you could do and lose games you should be winning. This can have a snowball effect and bring you to rage queue and lose like 20-30 games in a row. so keep that in check is a really, really important thing. Mental health is a really important thing which doesn't get talked enough about. So if you struggle with that, there are a lot of ways to get help with that. So inform yourself or talk with friends or something about that, if that's the reason of the tilt. The last point in the video I'm gonna talk about is practicing custom games. So we are finished soon. Every time you start a new game and get to lane, you farm either like Arpions or Jungle Camps. Practicing to do that as fast and efficient as possible will bring you a few extra seconds each game. The same can be done in other parts or areas like hiding monsters and basic combos of your Pokémon. You can train all of that more efficient in custom games, which you restart after doing that. This can be used to train starting moves etc. and will be especially high value for jungle players. Once the game is a bit more developed, at some point you will have lane matchups which will not be completely random, and things start to make sense in terms of how many mons fight each other on which lane and stuff like that. What you can do then with friends is to simulate the laning phase in certain matchups and practice the early game part of the game. This is called matchup practice and is really valuable experience. You basically come in the matchup with an idea how you want to play it basically as a strategy. The same goes for the opponent. The one who loses adjusts his strategy and the winner can do the same or stick to his strategy. Then it gets repeated several times. You basically do this like 5 to 20 times in a row and then you swap the mons and play the matchup in the different way around. Doing that, you refine your matchup analysis and think about how you can play based on what your opponent is playing and give you a big edge over your opponents if he has not done the same. Repetition will refine that more and more. You can also do the same with more than only your matchup and make it a full 5v5. This then would be called scrims. And if you end the scrim after early game, it's called blitz scrims. Both have really good value to improve in the game. I know this has been quite a lot of input, but let me repeat what we talked about and conclude. You should play in sessions and prevent autopilot and tilt. You should spam one Pokémon at a given time, but can swap what Pokémon you spam in set intervals, but don't always switch around every game. Mechanically less incentive Pokémon are a good thing to start on and pick up. Don't feel forced to play what's meta or trending, just stick to your guns. Review your games and focus on fundamentals and your intent. Watch skilled players and adapt their strength into your gameplay. Practice things in custom games which you can do there effectively. You can do matchup practice once your game is more developed. I hope you found this enjoyable and potentially even learned something from this video. I would advise you to rewatch it at some time in the future and maybe make even some notes. Now good luck and improving. This is in the next video. Bye.